the other box over at, right?
It's over there.
Yeah, I got the video going on. Okay. I just put it in the old place.
Okay.
Oh, it's okay.
So should we try to find a video? I think there's like a...
Yeah.
It's like a Ron Capps one or a Matt Hagen one. It's the...
See, Ron Capps qualified first.
Yeah.
So did Salinas.
Yeah.
That's cool. I like him. For some reason, I don't know why. I think it's used to hold the push rods in. So imagine with just the push rods and that, to line them up with your push rods. And then if you were to set it on the...
All of the...
That's what we might get.
Yeah.
You know, these little... Here, that wouldn't be there. Kind of looks that way just from...
Yeah, it's the same spacing.
Yeah.
Hey, watch this guy. Turn it up. Turn it apart. Oh. Then we gotta get some Hemi stick here, huh? We're gonna go for the Dodge sponsorship. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. 2 minutes and 38 seconds since that car rolled into the pit. Standing on it, and definitely a chance will be.
Oh,
okay. This cylinder. Okay, I want to see what happened to them. Push rods.
Yeah, the glare.
Yeah, the glare.
That makes it easier.
Yeah, yeah. I put that board under there to make it level, but it doesn't level.
Plus, it's less tippy for you, too.
Yeah.
I don't know if we're falling out. Okay, we got 5 minutes. Get to work.
Yeah.
So what do you want to do?
I don't know. So I'm trying to see if we, if that's really how I want to take that off.
Or did you want the intake first?
Yeah, let's look at, let's
should I put that intake valve cover back on maybe then?
No, because I think you got to have it off anyway.
Okay. To get, oh, yeah, the bolts.
Yep.
That's right.
Okay. So I think to pull the intake, we got to remove some fuel lines. At least one up front here.
Should we remove the headers so we're not walking around them? Or do you want to leave them out?
I don't know.
Do they look full? They look full. Not yet. No, I agree.
No, no. I thought of that too, but we got to be used to working around them headers.
Yeah, that's true. I think that's probably a good idea. Actually, yeah. At least to be around them and
yeah.
Not fucking.
I think that would be a
banger. Awesome shin door.
Yeah.
So you done with the arrow was over there, Rick, or no?
Yeah, yep.
I'm just going to do that, so flip over.
Yep. So let's see here. I guess we can kind of see, we can pull it off, and then we can see what's all attached to it. Right. I think it'll be whatever this line is. This line up front is separate. Everything else is attached to this here. So I wonder if we would simply remove these two lines.
This wire.
These two lines here then would stay with the intake, you know?
Yeah, all this will stay with the intake.
Yeah, all those will. How about this? This is a, I think it's like a high speed greens or whatever.
It's mounted for here. I mean, no, that's not mounted to the intake anymore.
Oh, this isn't?
No, that is, but this isn't.
These yeah. Oh, right.
Yeah, so it looks like you can leave that stuff alone if you want it.
So those four are easy enough to see. This I think is easy enough to understand. Let's see here. This is one line here I'm gonna take off. The wire for the supercharger reverse panel come off. It really is just
look like monster.
Just these two lines. I took all kinds of pictures of like how all these lines go up on the intake and everything, you know, because this goes up like this. This bolts the bottom of the bird catcher. Two of these went to the bird catcher, one went in the back, and then the two that went in the, remember those two were in the supercharger?
Yeah, I won't remember.
Or no, excuse me, these two were on the supercharger, these two were on the blower. And then I just took a good picture of these here, which I think I've already got good pictures of how all this goes. So we'll try taking these two lines off. Or no, that line could stay on, right?
Yeah,
that can stay
all
with
this.
That. Just this one, right?
Well, yeah.
Am I thinking of that right?
Yeah, because I don't want to go.
So far, with that, just as a heads up, what I've noticed on these are like 8 and 6. That's the B's are the ones that work for our stuff. ones that say B. Yeah, the B is seems to work on everything for ours. And that's all the tighter, I think all that stuff should be. Okay, just tight enough not to leak.
Yeah, because there's an O-ring, I would imagine, or something.
No, it's just a, it should be just a JIC 45 size. Okay, so let me get two plugs.
I was going to bring my flashlight.
Oh, yeah, I'll get you. I'll get you one. I got extra.
Yeah.
I found an extra one. I'll go get it.
I should get one to carry too, because I got one at work and I should have one to actually carry.
Is that one in there? Okay,
oh,
so
that's cool, you know.
Yeah.
Good deal.
So I think that'll kind of, that would kind of lay off here. Is that, am I right? I guess just a little more.
Those are not real delicate with working on them either.
No.
You know how we've been.
Yeah.
Because we're thinking of it as this,
lower rear. So this. This wiring for the supercharger, the reverse panels. Okay, so that makes sense, I guess, huh? Right, that would just hook up there, and then that would go around to the rear. Any break in that system would shut the engine off.
Oh.
It would blow up.
Yeah, this goes down here.
Okay, so this little line here, it's in this line, it's got to be fuel of some sort.
I'm just going to kind of watch and learn as you go, too.
Yeah.
Is that right, or you don't
got
to
it.
Or,
no, I think it's just kind of hang out for the time being, but I want to do, too.
So, yeah, understand it.
So I wonder if I should get a little tag for this that says intake front or something. That's kind of a...
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Now I'll grab your flashlight, too.
Save you a lot of headache later on, I think. You know, looking back at pictures and stuff, but...
Yeah.
Then you're sure when you're putting it in that it's... You're right, you're not just kind of... Yes. Hey, can you get... Play like music or a video or anything. Podcast. I don't care.
Yep, I get something for you.
I gotta not have too quiet.
I know you were saying that the other day. I like noise, but I'm just as good.
Yeah, I need. Maybe I should.
No, you're good. You no.
Maybe I should just do that, but I don't know. It's something. I gotta have background
kind of
noise.
Kind like even in the, like going out in the woods.
I like it when I'm there because then I can listen to birds and things, and it don't bother me.
Yeah.
But any other time, if I'm inside a building or whatever, I gotta have some. If it's too quiet, I don't know.
So I'm you'll be all right watching drag racing today, though, right?
Oh yeah, definitely. those little ramp things come with it, or did you?
I just bought them.
Bought those? That'd be nice for the trailer too, right?
Yeah. Yeah, it'll be a lot of things, but so when we rolled it in here to get the jack under it, we had to get another little jack and lift it up.
Oh.
I didn't like that. I didn't like putting a jack under the frame and everything. So I seen a lot of people at the races have those. So they just roll it in the pit and roll it on that right away. And then you lift up on with the jack.
Okay.
The pro jack. And they're in the way, I just slide them in the middle of the car or something. Okay. I'm just, I just sat them off yesterday.
Handy. Yeah, that's little shit like that just make things.
Yeah, cool. Yeah.
So how much ground clearance does it have in the front then?
It isn't much.
Uh-huh.
I don't know how much it is, but.
Huh. Yeah, I suppose you don't want to get any air under that.
Yeah.
Huh. Cool.
Yeah. So on the Spotify, if I want to just find the genre, because I've had classic rock before. Classic rock genre, but I can't find it. Choose one of those and then
You know what size those intake bolt nuts are?
No, I don't.
12 points. I'll figure that out.
Okay. I gotta get some little tags and a flashlight. Then I got like little bags and stuff, you know, we can put right on stuff, you know.
Oh. Oh, it's a 7/16. They're like little plastic containers.
I got a bunch more of them.
I got the little blue bins or whatever.
I got some more plastic containers. I got some bags I've been using too that I write on the bag and then put it with parts, you know.
Okay.
So,
a smaller one for these guys.
Yeah. Thank you. hey, personal lighting device.
Someday Ron Capps will be watching our videos. How'd they fucking do that?
Yeah, go back.
You guys watch that.
Replay that again.
I don't care. Watch it again. How's that Stockman team fucking doing that?
That fixed the transmission last minute, I think. The leak, you know?
Oh, yeah.
I took and
backed
this apart and figured it all out, and then took the shaft out and put an O-ring in it, and then I had it sitting all night up like this with oil in there. I hope anyway.
Yeah.
But then I think we put it in the car, then I'll drain it all, then we'll put new oil in it and see if I got it or not.
But okay.
It looks pretty good.
Yeah, it'd be nice to get all that shit.
Yeah.
I think you're doing it right, just take your time.
Yeah, I did. I've been just taking my time and
do it right.
Playing with it.
Oh, there's washers on there, but it's sort of like a lift.
Carefully, washers will probably stay, yeah.
Yeah, carefully lift it off so they don't fall out. Yeah,
and then we'll find them. And, okay. That sounds good to me. Okay, so I was going to put a little tag on that hose.
Down the road, I get too far from it, so. But yeah, like Sunday, you can have it so you could have like this wrench with all this.
Absolutely. I fully intend.
Like that wrench works perfect as far as I can tell for this job. It's nice and easy to get in. It's got the right angle.
I'm going to be buying some more wrenches like for each job.
Yeah. Because you know, different ones, shorter ones,
yeah,
finer. Ratchets, stricter, you know, just
yeah,
all that stuff. That's the part that I think will be fun, is try to just do it efficiently. Or whatever. I love trying to figure out efficiency stuff or whatever.
Yeah. And we get organized, where it doesn't take us long. I mean, we got to get our maintenance things down, or changing oil,
A lot of these teams are getting these young guys without a lot of experience. So they're coming in at green, but they're seeing things that the guys that have been doing it forever don't see.
Yeah.
And, you know, they don't really, you don't need the people's education. You kind of want somebody that, in their hearts, they want to do it and learn. And you're going to learn from them. That's it, just those six nuts in there.
All it is, huh?
Yeah. And you took off. That line was, what was this line called or whatever?
I just wrote intake thrust.
Okay.
So
what does it actually
line.
Do?
It's a fuel line. There should be a, well, I don't know. These solenoids and that, I don't know how all that works yet.
Oh, maybe that just really like gives it a shot.
Yeah, it's going to be part of that timing, fuel timing thing. It goes as it goes.
I guess I'll just concentrate on knowing clutch stuff. And I'll ask questions like that. So
we got to learn.
Yeah, we need to understand why it's done what it does. That way you can perfect it.
Yep. We will. So in theory, I might be ready to lift off. I want to think about putting that on this bench over here. So since I think the transmission is done, I was gonna maybe put the transmission under the
car.
It's a two guy project. I mean, I did it by myself, but it's better with two people.
I imagine it's gotta be fucking strong for the board.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Was and
oh, sorry.